previous video, I have already explained you the chapter. In this video, I will discuss some important topics related to the chapter. Basically, these are the notes for the chapter. First of all, we will see the theme. So that there are two themes. First is love and sacrifice, and the other is acceptance. So let's see. If there will be any question related to theme, you can even write it down like this as well. Okay, just in the form of a question answer. So the story is written in the first person as in the biographical mode. It is the perception of Kushwant Singh of his grandmother through his own eyes. So ye jo perception hai wo Kushwant Singh ka khud ka hai aur ye first person mein likhi gayi hai. That means ki Kushwant Singh jo narrator hai wahi isko narrate kar rahe hain. There is no second or the third person. A very heart-touching story that shows the special bond and connection between a boy and her granny and the changes which comes in their relationship as the time passes by. Time passes, there are many changes between the relationship of the boy and the granny, and this is how the story moves on, and this is how the story is about. Okay. From him, his grandmother was something close to idealism, and despite many differences in their likings, he always loved and respected her by heart. So she was loved by the narrator, though there were many differences. Bahut sare differences in their likings mein, as she didn't like the English medium school, she didn't like music lessons, but there were many large differences, but the narrator loved his grandmother. Her love for him was also very deep. Not only that, the grandmother was an epitome of love and sacrifice, which is highlighted as the main theme. Though bahut sare differences aaye puri story mein, in the end of the story their friendship almost got ended, but still they loved each other. They sacrificed them for each other. How they sacrificed? Just as an example of grandmother, when the narrator wants the private space for his own, then the grandmother sacrificed the relation between them and gave him the private space. So the love for each other, they loved each other, they didn't say anything to each other, but still they have love in their heart for each other. So that love and the sacrifice is the main theme of this chapter. Okay, the whole story revolves around her. She laid her heart not only for humans but also for animals. Similarly, she used to love the animals as well. Okay, like sparrow. She was very religious, but with the lapse of time, the grandmother is left alone, but she accepts that then and never complains. So जब वो अकेले हो गई थी एक पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम पे, जब नरेटर को प्राइवेट स्पेस चाहिए थी, शी वॉज लेफ्ट अलोन. शी जस्ट यूज टू स्पिन द व्हील, द यार्न बेसिकली, एंड देन द बेस्ट हाफ एन आवर ऑफ द डे वॉज फीडिंग द स्पैरोज. दिस वॉज द डेली रूटीन दैट शी कंटिन्यूड, एंड इन एडिशन टू दैट शी प्रेज अ लॉट. शी चैंट्स द prayer every time. So this was the daily routine of her, and she was left alone. This is what she did, and she just got busy in her own life, in her own world, without complaining to anyone. So acceptance of every situation that makes before you is another one, it is another theme. Thus the grandmother is also a strong woman, as she accepts whatever comes before her without any complaint. She just accepted whatever comes in her life. After her peaceful death, the sparrow even mourned her death as they stopped chirping, and they did not even eat the pieces of bread thrown before them. So here again love comes. See, either it is a human or it is an animal. Animal also connects to the people who they love. They also connect to the people who feeds them. So similarly, the grandmother used to feed the sparrows daily, and is the reason why the sparrows were mourning at the death of the grandmother? Because they had a sense of connection with the grandmother. At that day, they didn't chirp, neither they ate a single piece of bread. What they did was mourning at the death of the grandmother. Okay? So the love of sparrows for the grandmother emerges here. It is often the worst time in one's life when they realize that their true potential, as the grandmother became a strong woman after the departure of the author. So jab author university abroad padhne chala gaya, tab bhi the grandmother emerged as a strong woman. She was a strong woman, whatever came in her life, jo bhi unki life mein aaya, unhone bahut strongly usko accept kiya without any complaint, and she was always a constant. She was always constant, right? Okay. There's a question which is very important, that why Kushwant Singh described the portrait. In the portrait of a lady, Kushwant Singh basically tells her his relationship with his grandmother in three different phases of the life. See, jo title ka naam hai wo hai the portrait of a lady. Portrait मतलब होता है पेंटिंग है. कुशवंत सिंह जस्ट डिस्क्राइब्स द पोर्ट्रेट विथ वर्ड्स. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंड, जो वर्ड्स के थ्रू उसने पोर्ट्रेट बनाई थी. बेसिक इसका मीनिंग हिंदी में यही है कि वर्ड्स के बेसिस पर ही मेड अ पेंटिंग ऑफ हर ग्रैंड मदर, एंड दैट्स व्हाट ही डिस्क्राइब्ड. That is the why the title of the story is a portrait of a lady. There is no such portrait of the lady, but there was a portrait of made by words by the narrator. The relationship is great. She helps him with his work, drops and picks him from school, dressed him up. Then in the second phase, they go to live in the city. Grandmother has problems with the English medium school in which he now studies. She can't help with his studies. They don't get to spend the time together. She finds objection in the narrator's music lessons. She thinks music is a subject of lowly people. It is not for gentle people. So it upsets her. In the third phase, the author grows up. She attends university, their friendship kind of ends, and they couldn't find time for each other. So grandmother started developing and confining herself in her own world. This is what happened. They just made herself isolated to everything. She was left lonely, okay? And she confined herself. Confined मतलब उन्होंने बंद कर लिया अपने आप को अपने ही world में. When author comes back from the college, she behaves unusually and celebrates his homecoming, and eventually the loud singing makes her ill and then she dies. In the portrait of lady, author tries to show the decreasing relevance of grandmother in the narrator's life. So it's basically just the pura describe kiya relationship as a relationship between him and his grandmother is the declining relevance, the declining priority of his grandmother in his own life. Okay, so the title, the author Kushwant Singh describes his grandmother painting a word portrait for the reader. Word portrait matlab word ke through, word ki sahayata lete hue usne ek portrait, ek painting taiyar kari through this chapter, through this story of his grandmother. To him, with her pious, kind, understanding her and caring persona, she is true embodiment of the term lady. So, because she was poised, she was very caring, she was kind, that is the reason the title mein lady word used hua hai. According to the author, the grandmother may not have been pretty, but her inner beauty shown through her persona means personality, making her beautiful. So according to the author, वो अपनी ग्रैंड मदर को कंसिडर करता था कि वो ब्यूटिफुल है, बट शी इज़ नॉट प्रिटी. ब्यूटिफुल वाई? बिकॉज ऑफ हर इनर ब्यूटी. उनके अंदर एक इनर ब्यूटी है विच मेक्स हर केयरिंग काइंड एंड दैट इज़ वाई हर पर्सनैलिटी is very pious in nature and very understanding in nature. How she accepts everything without any complaint, how she loves the narrator, how she sacrifices for him. So all these things is her personality making her beautiful. That is why a lady word is used in the title. Now let's see the characteristics. So the story describes the entire phase of relationship which the author shared with his grandmother. In the early days of the author's life, his grandmother shared a strong bond with him. However, the tie of friendship loosened a little when they both shifted to the author's city house. So, जब सिटी हाउस में वो लोग शिफ्ट हुए तो थोड़ा सा उनका जो बॉन्ड था वो थोड़ा सा लूज हो चुका था. She became resentful of the things being taught in the English schools as she was very unhappy. जो भी इंग्लिश स्कूल में पढ़ाया जाता था बिकॉज शी वॉज नॉट दैट काइंड ऑफ लेडी. शी वॉन्टेड कि वो अपने ग्रैंडसन को हेल्प करे लेसन्स में जो वो नहीं कर पाती थी. एंड शी वॉज ऑल्सो वेरी अनहैप्पी क्योंकि इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल्स में गॉड्स एंड स्क्रिप्चर्स के बारे में नहीं इतना पढ़ाया जाता था एंड साइंस के बारे में ज़्यादा पढ़ाया जाता था. शी वॉज ऑल्सो वेरी अनहैप्पी वेन शी केम टू न्यू दैट the author is taking music classes in the school because she felt that it is a lowly art for low caste people. This art is not decent, what she thought. It was that. And she had a great interest in praying. She keeps on praying every time. Okay. Finally, the day came and the author... Finally, the day came and the author was to go to the university. This phase of the author's life was very painful for the grandmother and led to a complete separation of their relationship. The author got a room of his own and his grandmother led a life of seclusion. Seclusion means loneliness. However, in spite of changes in the course of lines, their feelings for each other remained unchanged. बहुत सारे चेंजेस आए बट जो उनकी फीलिंग थी वो अनचेंज रही. इवन वेन ही वॉज फीलिंग टू गो लीविंग टू गो अब्रॉड शी डिडंट डिस्प्ले एनी इमोशन बट प्रेड कंटिन्यूसली. जब वह अब्रॉड जा रहा था तब भी उन्होंने कोई इमोशन नहीं दिखाया था. शी वॉज वेरी कॉन्स्टेंट और कंटिन्यूसली प्रे करने करती रही. सेम वॉज हर रिएक्शन वेन द ऑथर केम बैक आफ्टर 5 years और वही रिएक्शन उनका 5 years का था. दैट इज़ द रीज़न शी एक्सेप्टेड एवरी थिंग वॉट एवर कम्स इन अर लाइफ. शी हैड अ ग्रेट सेंस ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग एज वेल एंड सैक्रिफाइसिंग एज वेल. ओके सो आई एम एंडिंग दिस वीडियो है. आई वॉन्ट यू टू गो थ्रू द एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड इफ आई हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क. थैंक यू.